With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hello students, in this question we have given optically pure plus 2-chloro-octane whose alpha is plus 40 degree reacts with aqueous NaOH in acetone to give optically pure minus 2-octanol whose alpha is minus 12 degree with partially racemized chloro compound whose alpha is plus 30 degree and the alpha of alcohol product is minus 6 degree. Then we have to calculate the percentage optical purity of partially racemized chloro compound and alcohol. Next, the percentage of inversion and racemization. Next, the percentage of front side and back side attacks. What interference can be drawn from the data in part A of the above example about the mode of secondary alkyl halide? And the last one is, give the rate expression in terms if the expression decrease the experimental changes for encourage SN1 and SN2. Let's solve the first one, that is asked percentage optical purity. We know optical purity is equal to observed rotation divided by rotation in pure enantiomer. We have to determine for chloro compound and alcohol. So for chloro compound, optical purity is equal to observed rotation in case of chloro compound given 30 degree. And for pure enantiomer, it is 40 degree. So, 30 divided by 40. And all are positive values. It is asked percentage optical purity. So, we will into 100. That is equal to 75%. So, percentage of optical purity for partially racemized chloro compound is 75%. Let's determine the value for alcohol. Percentage optical purity will be equal to observed rotation. In alcohol, observed rotation is minus 6 degree divided by rotation in pure enantiomer, that is equal to minus 12 degree. We have to determine in percentage, so we will into 100, that will be equal to 50%. Next question is, calculate the percentage of inversion and racemization. Here, plus 2-chloro-octane reacts with aqueous NaOH in acetone and gives optically pure minus 2-octanol. That means, in this reaction, both inversion and racemization products will be formed. For chloro compound, percentage optical purity is 75%, and for alcohol, percentage optical purity is 50%. Hence, inversion will be here. Optical purity of alcohol, that is 50%, divided by optical purity of chloro compound, that is 75. We need the percentage value, so we'll multiply with 100 and the value comes 66.6%. So percentage of racemization will be 100 minus inversion, that is 100 minus 66.6 is equal to 33.4%. Next it is asked, calculate the percentage of front side and back side attacks. We know in inversion only back side attack is possible. But in racemization, both back side and front side attack is possible. In racemization, half is backside attack and half is frontside attack. So percentage of backside attack is equal to inversion percentage, that is 66.6%, where all are backside attack. So 66.6 plus in racemization half of the total is backside attack, so half into 33.4, that is equal to 66.6 plus 16.7, that is equal to 83.3%. Now percentage of front side attack is equal to only half of the racemization product, that is equal to half into 33.4, that is equal to 16.7%. Next it is asked, what inference can be drawn from the data in part A of the above example about the mode of secondary alkyl halide? In part A, we have determined for chloro compound percentage of optical purity is 75%, and for alcohol the percentage of optical purity is 50%. Percentage of inversion is 66.6% and racemization is 33.4%. So there is more percentage of inversion than racemization. Inversion is generally shown by SN2 reactions, whereas racemization is shown by SN1 reactions, and there is more percentage of inversion than racemization. So for secondary alkyl halide. It can be said SN2 reaction is dominate over SN1 reaction or mechanism. Next question is, give the rate expression. We know the rate in SN1 reactions depends only upon the concentration of alkyl halide. But in case of SN2 reaction, the rate depends upon the concentration of alkyl halide as well as the concentration of nucleophile. Here the nucleophile is OH-. This is the required rate expression. Last question is, in terms of the expression, decrease the experimental changes for encourage SN1 and SN2. See here, SN2 reactions depends upon the concentration of OH- ion. SN1 reactions don't depend upon OH- ion concentration. So, if we will decrease the OH- ion concentration, what will happen? The value of K2 will be less. So, if we will decrease the OH- concentration again, so the K2 value will be negligible. In that case, SN1 reaction will be dominate. If we increase the OH- ion concentration, then what will happen? Increase the OH- ion concentration, then K1 will be negligible. In that case, which reaction will be dominant? SN2 reaction will dominate. So, increasing or decreasing OH- ion concentration, we can encourage SN2 reaction or SN1 reaction. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level, trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.